many people have been arguing that we talk less and act more. And I think we need to always try to appreciate ourselves. I think we need to congratulate ourselves the way this summit was organized. That to sign 10, there were 11 MOUs, practical. I say practical because a substantial part of them are already in the field implementing these MOUs. Greater numbers, 165 billion naira worth of investment. They are already in the field. The groundwork has been cleared. The bureaucracy and bottlenecks identified by the Excellency, I think they have to win. I can say if you listen to you for any bureaucracy or bottleneck, you will even occur. They are already in the field. They are working. The second component, very important, the power component. Most of them are already in the field. Our 7 just in discussion with the representative of Dangote, engineer, Mr. Ahmed, he told me that the black line for Dangote Consortium have already taken over the land provided by the state government, and they've already spent about $600,000 preparing for this project already. They are already working. The 3 billion private sector investment in the transformation of Kwari market, that is almost completed. 80% of the work completed. Some people have already started taking stock and ownership of some of the new transform market stores in Kwari market. That was the only contractor inside of the country that was over here actually signing this contract. And I can thank you all and all and all of them. So this is not business as usual. This is business that can do this time. It is why we have what we need is to actually tell the people at this summit actually provide the platform. So hopefully, by next year when we come, we look forward to another army of serious, practical investors to come to Calgary. So much has been said by the fact that Calgary holds great potential for investment. This provides not only the market that we keep on saying, yes, very critical, huge market. But beyond the market, what about the culture? Because you cannot find or acquire the culture easily. We have that commercial entrepreneurial culture that predates the creation of Nigeria, that predates the coming of the colonial masters, and it has its roots in the society that is still here. So the combination of the two, the market, the culture, provides huge potential for Calgary. So I say to all potential investors, welcome to Calgary. And don't miss the opportunity. Because I can assure you, the government of today is very, very serious. We understand. We don't take it as a joke. When they tell us that by 2050, the population of Nigeria will be about 400 million, who will be the largest, most populous nation on earth by 2050. And when you hear 2050, you may just be sitting in something very far away. No, no. It's just about 30 something years away from now. And 30 years when you reflect, it was a time when late Abubakar Mini was the governor of Kano. It was very far. Our population will grow that expression. One of the frightening things is one of the most costliest assets The land will still be the same. It is made. The land is like the system. Oh, we are just about 47 million. In the land, in the 70s and 80s, when we are approaching the hundreds, it is the same land that we are today talking of 170 million. It will be the same land in terms of size when it is 2050. That's why we have to initiate this action and be there in the next 10 years. We think this summit should wake us up and be key of this proposed leadership, projecting from what is waiting for us ahead. We all have great responsibility. I would call each and every one of us here on the farm side, please put your hands in the room in your mind to prepare for that commission on tomorrow. Thank you very much. Allah is keeping it possible. God bless you and take you all home. Thank you. Thank you.